next exercise we're going to come to is flat dumbbells. While I believe that incline movements should be predominant in the chest training routine, since that's what we're really trying to concentrate on building, you do need some flat as a variety. I like to not neglect any one body part exclusively. So for flat dumbbells, so I like to employ flat dumbbells in place of the usual typical flat barbell press. Now, you can every once in a while substitute the flat barbell press in, but it's not a good movement. If you ever talk to an orthopedic surgeon, and unfortunately, I've been to a lot of orthopedic surgeons because of my shoulder problems, they say that every single person who does a lot of flat benching has a torn anterior labrum, which is the cartilage lip that surrounds the shoulder joint. And when that stuff starts getting shredded, you start getting that like creaky pain in there and catchy feeling and just uncomfortableness. And that happens to all bench pressers eventually, especially flat bench pressers, he told me. And I've seen some x-rays and MRIs, you know, in med school from that. And so it's not something you want to be doing a lot of. Flat bench pressing is not the greatest movement. But the flat dumbbells are a little better in the sense that they don't lock you into a specific plane of movement. You can kind of adjust the dumbbells to where you're comfortable and where the shoulder joint is in a better position. So let's, with that being said, we're going to keep the form the same. And it's very similar to doing an overhead press like we did with shoulders. You want to keep the dumbbells close to your body at all times. You don't want them to wander out to the side. Okay, you want to keep them in the same plane of motion close to your body. Why? Because when the dumbbells are close to your body, that's where your strength band is. And that's the strongest you're going to be. In addition to that, you want to make sure the elbows are flared out to the side. If the elbows are flared out to the side, we know we're maximizing chest involvement. We're minimizing tricep involvement. Okay? As you can see, when we come to triceps, you know, when you do close bench pressing for triceps, you keep your elbows tucked in. So we don't want to do that now. We're working on chest. And once again, you want to keep the chest up high, the rib cage up high throughout the movement. Keep the deltoids back. Because if the deltoids start rounding forward, especially when you get tired, you're going to be cheating with your front delts. But we don't want them. So the set ends when you can no longer contract the pecs. Okay, we don't cheat. We don't cheat and use your front delts to get the rest of the repetitions up because we're stimulating another muscle that we don't want to. That leads to bad habits. Okay, so let's start off with the flat dumbbells. We're only going to do two sets here. So once again, we're going to go heavy and heaviest. I'd probably start off with probably the 120s because I'll probably finish off with the 150s. Whereas you guys may do a lot less than that. You got to find out what's comfortable for you. Remember, you should be able to get about 10 reps with this first warm-up set. You want to keep the dumbbells facing each other where the two bells are touching each other. So that your hands are not in a neutral position, but they're in a, I guess that would be considered a pronated position. And they're going to go straight up as if you were using a barbell. The same plane, okay? It's pretty simple. Okay, so let's pop the dumbbells up on your knees. And let's fall back into the movement. And keep the dumbbells real close to the body, okay? Right by the armpits, okay? And we're going to push straight up with the elbows out to the side. Chest raised up. Here we go. Begin. One. Good. All the way back. Two. All the way back to the pit of your arm. Three. Good. You can touch them together at the top if you want. Four. Okay, if you're keeping them close to your body, they're almost going to be touching anyway. Five. Good. Halfway. Six. Nice. Seven. Good. Three more. Eight. Nine. Come down nice and slow and up. 10. Good. Nice and slow on the way down. All right. Now come up with them and pop them on your knees and sit up with them. Put them on the floor. Good. Now when we get heavier, you're probably not going to be able to do that. You're probably going to just dump them off on your sides of you. Okay. Make sure that there's no dumbbells on the floor already. When you drop them, or you're going to crush your fingers. Okay. I've seen that happen to a few people before. You drop your arms down to put your dumbbells down right beside you. There's another set sitting there. Your fingers get caught right between where you're dropping the dumbbells and the ones on the floor, and there's a big problem, okay? So we don't want that to happen. All right, so let's stretch out the pecs a little. Grab onto a wall or a pole. Just get a nice stretch. They should be really warmed up. You already did your incline presses. We're going to go to our working set of flat dumbbells right now. Like I said, I'm going to grab the 150s. You're going to grab whatever weight is applicable for you. We're trying to get about 4 to 6 good reps. I'm going to push you through 6 probably. You may need a little help from your training partner or someone in the gym. So, like once again, whenever you're doing chest, try to get a spot from someone. Important thing I should have mentioned earlier, there's no need to use a belt when you're doing chest, okay? Why is that? Well, a lot of bench pressers do it because they arch their back and cheat a little bit. And so for them, it's a safety mechanism. You shouldn't be cheating. bodybuilders should not be cheating on this. And the reason we wear a belt is twofold. One, to prevent the back, you know, when it's in a compromised position. We know the back is not a compromised position during benching because you're laying on a bench, and that's protecting the back right there. The second reason we wear a belt is to increase intra-abdominal pressure to generate power, whether that could be on a squat or a leg press. When we're doing chest, we're not increasing intra-abdominal pressure to get the weight up. We're increasing intrathoracic pressure in the chest cavity. Belt's not going to do anything around your waist at this point. It's just going to cut your breathing down. You don't need the belt for this. All right, let's get our dumbbells ready, and we're going to be ready to do our next set and our final set here for dumbbells. This is another big working set, so we really want to put 100% concentration into it. It's not like you got three more sets to do. This is it, so really concentrate on this. All right, here we go. Lift them up on your knees, pop them up, and let's fall back into the movement. Chest raised up. Here we go. All right, and when we're done, we're going to pop them on the floor. Let's go. Ready? Up. One. Good. Two. Nice and slow on the way down. Three. Good. Halfway. Four. Come on, squeeze. I know the weight's heavy. Come on. Five. You want big pecs? Up. Six. One more. One more. Even if you need help. Come on. Squeeze. 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 Keep those elbows back. Chest up. Good. Come down nice and slow. Slow, slow, slow. Drop them off to the side. Good. Excellent. Good. Fantastic. Excellent set. You should be very proud of yourself. We just got through a grueling workout. We're not done yet, so stay tuned for the next exercise.